Hello Beavers! This week for your taking home activity, we are going to do part of your space badge. Now, I know that a lot of you are interested in space and a lot of you know a lot about space. So this week we are going to look a little bit at stars and groups of stars which are called constellations. Now, stars themselves are, well, they appear like little twinkly things in the sky, but actually scientists have found out that stars are large, huge balls of burning gas that are millions and billions of miles away from here. The nearest star to Earth is the Sun, which is very far away. But to give you an idea of how far the next star away is, if we were to jump in a rocket and travel to the next nearest star to Earth after the Sun, it would take us 100,000 years to get there. It is so far away, which is quite mind-blowing, really. So what we are going to do is learn a little bit about groups of stars, as I said, which are called constellations. Now, as I say, some of you might know some of these because if you look up into the sky and on a clear night, you might see some that look more like a pattern. And that's what a constellation is. It's not because they're actually near each other. They're actually very far away from each other. But from here, they can look like a pattern in the sky. And over the years since humans have looked up to the skies, they've called them different names. And some of them might be named after stories and characters in stories, like Greek gods or animals in stories, sometimes even after monsters or beasts. And some of them have been called after everyday objects. In fact, there's some that you might have heard of called the Big Saucepan, which is quite a funny thing to think of. But what we'll do is we're going to make your very own star projector that will help you to learn about a constellation, and then you'll be able to show your family your very own star projector constellation in your house. So what you have in your home bag is you should have a little toilet roll tube, a little bit of tin foil, and you'll also need some sellotape and a really nice sharp pencil. And the reason that you need it sharpened, you'll see in a wee minute. So take your toilet roll tube, pop your tin foil over the top and press it down to the edges and get it nice and tight. Now, it probably would stay quite well like that, but just to hold it on a bit more securely, take a little bit of sellotape and pop it on either side. Now, the next part is to decide which constellation you'd like to make. So on the back of your information sheet that you've got, you'll see some patterns here of some of the most common ones that people know. But you can also look on the online Scout Manager. If an adult will show you, there is another information page on that under the Space Badge Part 2, and that will show some other constellations. I've also put a couple of websites on. One is for the European Space Agency, and they tell you a little bit about the stories behind some of these constellations. So I have decided to do what's on your sheet as Ursa Major, but some of you might have heard of the Big Bear or the Great Bear or the Big Dipper, and it's also called the Big Saucepan. So it's this one here I'm going to do. So I've got my toilet roll tube here, and holding it quite firmly, gently make the holes in your tin foil. So see, if you've got a sharp pencil, it will go in a bit more easily. So that's the bottom of my wee saucepan there, and then here's the handle going up here and there. Now, I'll turn that round so you can see it. So I've copied this one here. And what you need to do now it's best if you turn off all the lights in your room, but if I do that now, then the camera won't show anything. So I'm just going to take the torch, shine it underneath it, and if we look up to the ceiling, you'll see that I've made my own projection of the Big Dipper. Now that you're a wee bit more familiar with these, when it's next a clear night, you might like to go outside and see if you can spot some, and you might learn some others. I know that from North Berwick we often do see Orion, the Hunter, Cassiopeia, and the Big Dipper, or the Big Bear and the Little Bear. So See if you can spot some of those. And once you've made your projector, make sure you take a photo. You don't have to take it off the ceiling if it doesn't work, but if you take a picture of your projector and send it in to us, then that'll be the next part of your space badge. So have fun, and I can't wait to see what you make. Okay, bye-bye.